Julian here, and today I'm going to be showing you how to make music in the style of Tessella. As usual, you can get the project file and samples from this video in the description. And yeah, let's dive in. So the first sound that I have here is this little noise which plays in the background. It sounds like this. And yeah, so all this is just some simple noise. It's just in the background to kind of give it some atmosphere. And then the only effect I have on there is this EQ8, which is doing a bit of a high pass. This is what it sounds like without it. And then with, so yeah, just cutting out some low end. So then the next thing that I have here is this techno kick, which sounds like this. So the way that I made this sound was basically with this one kick sample, and I put it in an instrument rack. So in the instrument rack, I have two chains. The first one is just the dry kick. And then the second one is that same kick sample, but with some effects. So the first effect I have on here is this reverb, which sounds like that. The dry wet is all the way up, and it's just giving it this kind of like atmosphere and sort of, you know, ringing out. After that, I have this amp, which sounds like this. And you can hear what that's doing is making the reverb mono, as well as it's sort of like bringing out the low end in it. And then finally, I have this low pass filter, which is just sort of cutting out the high end and soloing that low end. And yeah, that's what makes sort of the rumble. So then after that, I have some effects on the instrument rack. The first one I have here is this limiter, which is just sort of turning everything up and making it like really big and boomy. Here it is without it. And then with it. So yeah, I was just kind of like blowing everything out and giving it that like big techno kick kind of sound. This is an important technique for Tessella's music. He uses this a lot. And then after that, I have the saturator, which just has a bit of drive, and the wave shaper, which is set like this. It's just kind of bringing out like the transient of the kick more, I feel like. So yeah, so that's the kick. And then the next thing I have here is this group, which sounds like this. So what this is it's two layers. It's first this operator hi-hat, which sounds like this. So this is just a little hi-hat I made with operators playing 16th notes. All it is some white noise going into a bandpass filter. It's there for energy, which I'll explain more of in a bit. But yeah, so then the next thing that's in here is this little break chop, which sounds like this. And so all this is a sample from a drum break that I chopped out, and what I did was I pitched it down and I quantized it so it fit with the beat a bit better. And then what I have on here is I have a saturator, which is set like this, so I have the drive up a bit, the wave shaper like this. It's just kind of shaping the sound. Here it is without it, and then with. So yeah, it's giving it like that kind of distorted sound. And then I just have an EQ8 cutting on some low end. So then on the group here, what I have is, first off, I have this compressor, which is just kind of similar to what that limiter was doing on the kick. Just kind of like, you know, bringing everything up and like really giving it that big kind of overcompressed sound. After that, I have this amp, which is on the bass setting. And yeah, it's just kind of coloring the sound a little bit. Here it is without it. And then with it, you can also hear it's bringing everything into mono. But yeah, this just, you know, colors the sound. Like I said, for Tessella's music, since it is so colorful and textured, it's important to do stuff like this on everything to give it some kind of color and texture. So yeah, and then after that, I just have a saturator. Pretty simple. It's just kind of, you know, adding a little bit of girth to the sound. And then finally, I just have an EQ8 cutting out the low end. So that's this. And yeah, like I was saying, this operator I had is just there for energy. Because if you listen, what happens is it comes out of this part, and then there's like these hi-hats. And so if you don't have these 16th notes hi-hats, it feels a little bit less fluid. But if you have them, I felt like it makes the transition between those two little things kind of a little bit smoother. So yeah, so then the next thing I'm going to show you here are these two drum breaks. They sound like this. So what this first one is I took this drum break. And what I did was I put it in here, I chopped it up, and I pitched it up a bit, and then I have it going through some effects. So the thing here is mostly with the chopping. You can see it's kind of like this quick pattern where I just grabbed the snare and just kind of kept it going from there. This is a really popular technique. Tessella uses it, a ton of other people use it. And yeah, this is how I did it here. And then the reason why I have two breaks is because it's sort of like an A-B kind of thing. Like, this one is a little bit slower and lower pitched as well. And then this one is faster. So it's kind of like an A part, like an A section and a B section to the drop. So yeah, so then on this first one here, what I have is I have a compressor, just kind of compressing it. You can hear that's definitely, you know, hitting pretty hard. I turned the attack up a little bit so it wouldn't mess up the transients too much. And yeah, then after that I have the saturator, which is shaping it like this. So I'm just kind of using the wave shaper to control the sound a little bit. This gives you a lot of tonal and sonic possibilities if you use the wave shaper on drum breaks. So I was just kind of trying to shape it to my own, to be more my own thing. And then after that I just have a utility converting it to mono because there's a little bit of weird stereo stuff in the original. And then finally I just have an EQ8 cutting out the low end. So then on the second drum break I have pretty similar stuff. Basically I just have a saturator here, so pretty similar, just kind of shaping the sound a little bit. It's more like trying to change it tonally than it is trying to distort it with these saturators on the drum breaks. But yeah, and then after that I just have an EQ8 cutting out the low end. So those are the drum breaks. Those are like pretty important, and I just wanted to show you kind of some techniques I used with those. So, and the next thing that I have here is the 707. It sounds like this. So this is actually Ableton's 707 core kit. Tesla uses a ton of drum machine samples, like 707s, 909s, 808s, stuff like that. And I wanted to use the hi-hats from a 707 in here to sort of, you know, beef this up a bit. But I figured what better way to do it than to just use Ableton's 707 core kit, because everybody has that. So you could do this on your own as well. But yeah, so basically what I'm doing is, like I said, I have this kind of like ravey pattern playing here. It's just the closed hi-hat and the open hi-hat. And then what I have on that for processing is, first I have this amp. So similar to with that other little hi-hat group up there, I'm just using this to kind of color the sound. I have the gain down a bunch, the treble up a little bit, and I set the dry wet like that. So you can hear it's just giving it a little bit more vibe and kind of fitting it more into this track. And then finally, I just have an EQ8 boosting up some high end. So yeah, that's just kind of, you know, bringing it back a little bit. So this really just sort of works with the drum breaks. If you listen to it without it, it has a lot less energy, and it's because a lot of this kind of hype is in the high end, like the, like I said, like the energy, the hype, the stuff that makes you, that just gets you hyped up is a lot in the high end. So adding these hi-hats on top of here can really help to boost that and just kind of, yeah, beef it up a bit. So then the next thing I have here is this clap, which sounds like this. So this is just playing in the B section of the drop. It's just this kind of like nice, powerful clap sample. And all I did was I just put it in here, and then I put a saturator on it. So I turned the drive up a bit. Playing around with the wave shaper, there's a little bit of that. And yeah, it's just kind of like a nice, powerful clap. Not really too much to say other than Tesla usually goes for more like kind of like bigger bodied claps like this one. So then the next thing I have here is this little vocal chop. It sounds like this. So it's just like a little ravey kind of like vocal stab. Here's the original sample. So I just kind of took it, pitched it a little bit, put it in a sampler. And then what I have on here for effects is I just have an EQ8 giving it a bit of high end or a high end boost. And that's going into this erosion, which just gives it some nice kind of digital sort of like distortion slash like bit crushing. This is an important effect for Tesla's music. He uses it a lot, so I wanted to use it on this thing. And then I have that going into this echo, which is set to be pretty quick. This is just adding a bit of space, because without it, it can get kind of, it can be kind of like dull. But this gives it some nice space, like I said. And then finally, I just have an EQ8 cutting out the low end. So this is pretty simple. It's just playing on the upbeats. This kind of helps to give it a bit more hype as well. You can hear when I turn it off, it's not as cool. And this is definitely something Tesla uses a lot, like these ravey kind of vocal stabs. So the next thing I'll show you here is this first bass, which sounds like this. So the way that I made this was with operator. It's just a simple FM sound. Basically, I have three sine waves And then the second and the third are up an octave. Those are going into this bandpass filter, which has the frequency being controlled by this LFO, which is set like this. So that's what's giving it the movement. You can see when I turn off the bandpass. So then that's going into the saturator, which is just, all I did on here was just turn up the drive a bit to kind of bring out some of the like higher harmonic stuff. Here it is without it. And then with it, so yeah, just kind of beefing the sound up a bit. And then the only other thing about this sound is the glide. So the way that I did that pitch bend there that you hear there as well as here is basically I set the voices on here to one, so it can only play one voice at a time. And then I have the glide on here, and the time is set like really long. So that's what's allowing it to have these two notes that are so long and just go down like that over the course of this little like 2-bar clip. So yeah, so pretty simple there. And then on the second one, it's just 2 octaves down as opposed to one. So then the next bass that we have here, the next sound we have here is the second bass, which sounds like this. So just kind of like a dirty sort of bass sound. The way that I made this was also with operator. It's also 3 sine waves. And then what I have on the second one here is it's up 4 on the coarse pitch or the coarse tuning. And I have the envelope set like this, so it's kind of like giving it that attack. And yeah, and then this third oscillator is also pitched up an octave with the coarse tune. And I have the fine tuning set there. So it gives it a bit of detune kind of weirdness. And then I have those going into a bandpass filter, which also has an envelope on it, just similar to the one that's on oscillator B. And yeah, then finally, that's just going into a saturator, which is giving it a bit of drive. And you can see I have the wave shaper on there as well. So yeah, you can hear that just gives it kind of like the distortion. So this was similar to the breaks. I wanted it to be kind of like an A and B, like two different types of basses that I've heard Tesella use, sort of like this more distorted, ravey one, and then like the long, like UK style bass, I guess you would say. So then the next thing that I have here is this pad, which sounds like this. So the way that I made this was basically I took this chord stab, like an old school style pad, and I put it into this granular synth. I used the granulator, it's just a device for Ableton. But basically what a granular synth is, if you don't know, this is a technique that Tesella uses a ton. I heard this in a ton of his music. But what it is it's essentially just a sampler, but it plays back different parts of the sound. So like, you can see this yellow thing, this yellow line that's moving around. That all those places it's moving around to, that's where it's playing from the sound. So a regular sampler would just play through like all the way. This one is grabbing different parts of the sample. So that's what I did there. And then I have that going into a chorus here. So it just gives it a bit of kind of like space. And then I have that going into a saturator, which is, that's what's giving it like the grit. And yeah, I thought that was pretty important for the style. And then finally, I just have this echo here, which is just pretty fast. It just gives it a bit more space. I didn't have a reverb or anything, so I used this echo. And the echo is kind of better for the style, too, because it tends to have more of that kind of like dirty, old school style sound. So yeah, so this is pretty simple, but definitely important. Like, if you want those kind of like warping, like chord synths, like I like to think of it as like old school with a bit of new school. This is definitely a great way to do that because the granular synth, yeah, definitely makes it sound like it's warping around quite a bit. So then the next thing under that is the staccato string, which sounds like this. So this is just a sample of like some strings playing staccato, which means like very quickly and short. So like that dun dun dun. And then what I have it doing here is it's just playing quarter notes. So it gives it a bit of rhythm in this part. And this is something that Tesella does a lot because he tends to have parts like this. Like it'll be like a break where it's like no drums and just melodic stuff. And then it'll go like that into like full drums and bass. So I wanted to have something in here that gave it some rhythm so you could count it a little bit easier. And yeah, that's just what this is. And that's just got a little bit of reverb on it for some space. So then after that, I have this other drum break, which is just kind of a fill down here. It sounds like this. So the way that I made this was I had this drum break. And I just grabbed it, put it in here, I pitched it down, and obviously, you know, it's warped in time with the track. And then what I did was I took, if you see this here, I just split this thing and reversed it so it would be kind of like... just kind of a simple effect. And then for effects on there, what I have is I have a saturator, which is set like this, so... you can hear that's what's giving it, like, that grit. And then I have a bit of an echo, which automates. You can see at the end there, it kind of comes up. This is something I heard in a lot of Tesella's music, because he'll use drum breaks like this as kind of like fills, and typically he'll put a little bit of delay on it when it's like going to have like an open part after that where there's no other drums. So yeah, that's just kind of that. And then the last thing that I have here is this little old school rave effects sound. It sounds like this. So this is just a simple effect, I believe, yeah, I pitched it down a bit, and I just put it through some echo. It's just nice here for this part where everything cuts out, because if I don't have anything there, I feel like it doesn't flow as well, whereas this thing makes it a really seamless transition, and it also allows you to kind of impart like a sort of old school rave thing in there as well, since that is such a recurring theme in Tesella's music. It's nice to use little effects like this to kind of, like, remind the listener and just give that vibe. So that's really it for this one, you know. Mostly I just wanted to show you kind of, like, some of the techniques working with drum breaks and, you know, working with different samples and kind of putting together, like, techno and old school jungle and rave and hardcore elements to make this really, really cool blend of music. So that's going to be it for this tutorial. Make sure to let me know what you think of this video in the comments. And make sure to like this video as well as subscribe. You can get the project file and sample from this video in the description. And my social media you can also check out, which is on the screen right now. Thank you so much again, everybody. And I will see you tomorrow with another tutorial.